Hey guys, so I'm just about to do my freelance, which I'm very excited about. So it's Saturday, it's the 27th, so it's Halloween. So, well, I know it's not officially Halloween, but it's Halloween weekend. So I've been going out painting faces and just having a good time. So I'm not going out tonight. Oh, this is so much better lighting. I'm not going out tonight. Washing. Let's try and get this started. So by the time I get home, it's going to be really late and I just want to chill. I'm in London next week, which I'm really excited about. And also I've not been very well, I've been a bit poorly. So yeah, so I've literally been running around getting last minute things for my freelance. So like contacts and like hairspray, you know, like coloured hairspray and things like that. So, but yeah, I'm going to do one girl as Beetlejuice and another girl is going as like a corpse bride. So that should be very exciting. I'm very excited. I've not done Halloween, obviously, for a year, but I've not really done anything creative for a long time. You know, I do like my looks on Instagram, but I've not actually done like a proper creative freelance job. So this is good. It's good. I love being creative. And it's the first year as well, but I'm actually doing it freelance. Like, normally I would do it at the shop when I was at Illamasqua. So, yeah, that's one of the reasons why I'm not dressing up as well. Because I'm going to be running around to, like, hotel rooms and stuff and carrying all these kits. So, I don't really want to be running around dressed up as, like, a skeleton and stuff. So, yeah, so I'm in London on Tuesday for training, so I'm going to film that. My friend, B, is going to be joining me. She's doing training with me as well. She's on first date, which is on Monday, but by the time this vlog comes out, it'll be in after, so you can watch it on catch up. But, yeah, she said that she wants to be in my vlog, which is going to be cool. But I'll film a little bit later, like, maybe the looks that I've created, and then finish off the day, and then onto a busy week next week. So see you in a bit. Hey guys, so just got back and just got loads of snacks for movie night. I look really dead. Look at my lips, they look so blue, but they're not. It's really bad lighting. Gavin's arrived.
No, I am.
He has.
No, I am.
Well, you're right in the video, so you have.
No, I'm a figment of your imagination.
So I just finished my freelance, went really, really well. The girls looked amazing, and then I did like a quick vampire at the end. We did Beetlejuice, and then we did like a dead bride, and then I did a quick vampire look, which took me like maybe 10 minutes, if that, probably less. Literally just put foundation all over him, set it with a bit of powder, contouring, bit of blood, and then he put his teeth in, and he was going to do it himself, bless him, and I was like, I don't mind doing it, I can do it quick for you. But yeah, I can't believe how like pale and purple my lips look. Like, what is going on? I look dead. So yeah, so me and Gavin are going to have a movie night now. So we've got loads of snacks. So we got like Doritos. Oh, I wonder if this will help with the colour balance. No, we've got Doritos. We've got popcorn. Toffee popcorn is my favourite. We've got Pringles. What else? We've got hummus and sour cream dip, which Gavin's into. I'm more of a hummus person myself. But yeah, this one is roasted red pepper hummus. Love it. And yeah, just junk food. So we're going to enjoy our film. We're going to watch Killer Clowns from Outer Space. I'm going to go make a quick cup of tea, and then we're going to enjoy our movie. So hope you all have a good day, and I will see you in London. Mwah. Bye. Say bye, Gav.
Bye, Gav.
Hey, guys. So, just got into London. Feeling very old today. And I'm here with my gorgeous friend, B.
Hi, okay.
So, you might have recognised her from First Dates. She was on it last night. She did very, very well. How has the response been, B?
Do you know what? It's actually been really positive. Like, I thought it was going to be negative, but it's been really good. So, so good. Even though I cried, but...
What, you cried on the... Well, you cried on TV. She cried on the episode, but did you cry after it?
I was crying at home last night, you know.
Why?
Because my mum was crying, so she made me cry because she feels sorry for me, but it's all about living.
It was very emotional, so oh, we're going in daylight. You can see how ugly I am now, aren't you? Yeah, it was very emotional. It's over there, we need to go in here.
Yeah, I need to find a bin as well.
I should stick it there. It was very emotional. Bin, there's a bin there.
Bin
man. It was very emotional, but she did really good. I was sat on the train watching it and she did very good. So we're going to training now for London. Can we put this in your bin? Oh, yeah. Thank you.
Thank you.
So we're going to go and get the train, the underground. We're going to do training for Fenty.
Fenty Beauty.
So yeah, we'll catch you soon. You can follow us on our adventures. Take care. Bye. So just got into my hotel room. Just quickly taking my makeup off because we've just done training and I'm really funny about other people doing my foundation, so I needed to take it off. Bare skin right now, and then I'm gonna quickly redo it because I think I might go out for like something to eat or just get a drink or something. So yeah, so this is my hotel room. It's pretty nice actually, so it's the Holiday Inn, but it's actually pretty decent. So this is the bathroom, just your standard Holiday Inn. Hey everybody, so I literally have like 1500 layers on right now. I've got a vest, then I've got a long top, then I've got a jumper, then I've got my hoodie, then I've got my leather jacket and then my jeans. Okay, so yeah, you've got the bath and a shower and then you've got like a closet where you can hang up your things. What's this? I don't know what they are, but I've got a dressing gown. Oh, there's an iron. Oh, there's a hairdryer in there as well. Oh, if I'd have known there was a hairdryer, I wouldn't have bought mine. And you've got a long mirror. And then I've got the bed. Just turn some lights on. There we go. Yeah, it's really decent. What book have we got? The Complete A to Z Dictionary of Dreams. Oh, that's pretty good. Beats having a Bible in the room, doesn't it? We've got some pictures. TV. And then, what's this? Oh, a little safe. And then things. So I've just put my makeup and that down there. And then, oh, there's some popcorn. A Mars bar. I wonder if we can have these. I wonder if you have to pay. Oh well, I don't think you do. So yeah, let me prop my camera up. Yeah, that'll do. So yeah, I'm here for Fenty training, which is, it's been pretty good. It's been pretty good so far. So I'm here for one night, I'm in London. So I am in this Holiday Inn. I don't know where this one is actually, in Regent's Park, Holiday Inn in Regent's Park. So yeah, it's pretty good. So I'm gonna quickly just do my makeup. But today we've been learning kind of like the Fenty face, you know, and how to like do the makeup on a customer. And to be honest, like, it's stuff that I kind of do in my job anyway, because I've been with Fenty since February. And I was supposed to go on training quite a while ago, but I didn't end up going because it was so last minute and I had freelance, so I couldn't go. So my friend who I work with, Bea, is down. I think she's having a nap right now, bless her. But yeah, I've managed to fit everything in this backpack. I'm so impressed because normally I have like a gigantic suitcase, but I was like, do you know what? I'm gonna bring my backpack. Because if I have a suitcase, I tend to just bring the most random stuff ever. And I end up just bringing things that I don't even need, like I don't even use. I thought if I bring my backpack, it means that I won't have to worry about having 50,000 different outfits because, you know, I'm not going to think about it. I'm going to have a bare minimum that I can bring down. And you know what? It's like being a lifesaver because it means that I, you know, I haven't had to like run around with a big suitcase. I'm just using my shade and light palette I need to try and find a different contour palette. So if anybody has any ideas, just let me know. I absolutely love travelling. Like, I do like travelling. I mean, I don't necessarily like staying over. You know, I do like having my own bed. But, you know, it has to be done. You know, and I've got it out of the way. But I hate being away from home. I like having my own bed. I like just knowing where everything is. Whereas when I was younger, I used to love staying in, like, different hotels and just getting away. But now I'm not really that bothered about it. Yeah, I definitely have changed as I've gotten older. You know, I'm not as adventurous as I used to be. Like, I'm not as wild as I used to be. Like, before, I used to always want to go out and party. And now I just like to chill. I like my own space. You know, I like to just sit at home with a cup of tea, just watching TV. I'm just using Fenty eyeliner. It's such a nice eyeliner. It's got such a, like, little fine tip. It's really good to get to the lash line. And this is literally, like, my quick everyday makeup. If I've got somewhere to be, and then I'll just shove, like, my makeup on in a rush. I don't really spend much time on it now. You know, I can get ready quite quickly. Again, I think it's just because as I've gotten older, I'm just so much more comfortable with myself and being in my own skin that I don't really feel like I need to plaster loads of makeup on to feel comfortable. Yeah. So, did anybody watch WWE Evolution? Like, how amazing was that show? Like, it was incredible. I'm so, like, glad that WWE gave women the opportunity to be able to, you know, just be free, and they just let, you know, women have their own pay-per-view, you know, and just gave them that chance to show that, you know, they can do exactly what the guys do. And it was so nice to see Lita back. Like, I literally just flipped out when she did her moonsault and when she did, like, her Hurricane Rana. I was like, yes, go for it. You know, and I was watching it live as well, so I woke Gavin up. It was quite funny, to be honest. That will do. So I'm going to use a little bit of MAC Strobe Cream. But yeah, like, I felt really bad because I just don't like people doing my foundation. Like, I've never met anybody that does it how I like it. You know, people either, like, I always say I like a medium to full coverage. But I always feel like, no matter what, no one does it as heavy as I like. People just do it quite sheer. You know, I like it very, very full, but I like it medium by, you know, I like it full in the areas that need covering up. So if I've got, like, a problem area, I like to cover it up. Oh, I bet I've run out of foundation. I think I've run out. Okay, though, because I've got a little tester pot. I use that when I'm going back. I don't have to put makeup on in the morning because we're doing more training, so I get an extra longer lie-in. So I'll get up, I'll probably just do my hair, and then I'll get some breakfast, and then go to training, and then we're doing Halloween looks tomorrow, so that should be quite exciting. I think I'm just going to do, like, either a skeleton or, like, Harley Quinn or something. Something that's not overly complicated. Because we'll only be taking it off anyway. Like, I'm not walking around London with crazy makeup. So I'm using MAC NC37. Just Studio Fix Foundation. Literally, like, my go-to foundation. But yeah, I just thought, while I was in London, I would just chill. have a bit of a wander, do a vlog, and I've not been able to film any of my training, you know, which is a bit annoying, but, you know, I'm here to kind of work, aren't I, not film videos, so I thought I would just jump on camera and film. But yeah, I just want to also say, like, everybody has been so amazing since, you know, that the BBC Two Politics live show, you know. I've had a few people criticise me and people comment on it, you know, and saying that I have no idea what I'm talking about, you know, and that, you know, people, like, troll, saying I'll never be a real woman, and it's like, that's, like, beside the point, like, I'm not saying I'll ever be a real woman. I'm just saying that, you know, I should have equal opportunity as a woman, as a transgender person, you know. Why should I be any different? You know, and it's like, yeah, people can point out that I was born different, you know, but it's like, at the end of the day, we're all human beings. We're all here to live with one another. Why can't we all just get on and just get on with life? Why does everybody have to make it so hard for everybody else? You know, and it's like, yeah, I get people will take advantage. You know, some people will take advantage of the system, but not everybody will. And I don't think one person should tarnish an entire community. You know, it just baffles me. I just don't get it. I just think in this day and age, we should be allowed to live and be who we are without people putting an opinion on it. You know, we've had so many LGBT rights fought for, well, in fact, not even B, to be fair, because I feel like that's still a community that is very misunderstood. You know, and it's like my partner is pansexual, so he doesn't really see gender as gender. You know, he just likes the person for who they are, not what they are. But even then, that's still very confusing. And even I have to admit, like, it can be very confusing. I've gone out with, you know, a bisexual in the past, and I did think, oh, you know, because they like both, does that mean that, you know, they want a boyfriend and a girlfriend? But it's not the case. So I'm going in with Il Maschio Gel Sculpt. I told you this is literally the most rushed makeup ever. And when I was getting ready this morning to come to London, like, it was so early, and I was like doing this exact makeup to come down on the train, because we have to wear makeup, like, when we get here, just so they can kind of see, like, you know, what we would probably do on counter. My jacket is making loads of noise. I wonder what Bee's doing. I think she's had a nap. I've got a feeling she won't want to go out. Because it has been such a long day and we were both really tired, and I've got a massive headache that I can't shift. But I just feel like while I'm down here, maybe I should just go out for like an hour. Even if it's just to get something to eat, even if it's at McDonald's, you know. I think I get Holiday Inn confused with like travel lodges and stuff like that. But I mean, the travel lodges were like decent, you know. I mean, the main thing that you use hotel rooms for is to sleep, and that's about it. You know, I'm not really going to spend much time in here, I don't think. So it's only one night. Why go in an expensive hotel? It's just a waste of money. Okay, so I'm using Il Maschio 115 Powder Foundation. Just to quickly give a little bit of a matte highlight just to my skin. And then a little bit of highlight. Just a little bit. I'm using a YSL. It's nearly run out and I'm so upset because it's a limited edition one. You can't get it anywhere, but it's incredible. Like, look at that glow. Oh. And when I told the girl who sold me it, She was like, Drew, you need to use it for special occasions only because you won't be able to get it anymore, and it's amazing. I was like, I know, it's so good. So good. Right, last is brows and then lips. So I might put my lip on now. I'm going to use a little bit of MAC. This one is Bow. Only a little bit. Just dab it. And then I'm going to finish off with a little bit of Fenty Gloss Bomb in Diamond Milk. Eyebrows, and that's pretty much it. So I'm gonna put Anastasia Beverly Hills. This is the shade Taupe, it's their dip brow. Again, I'm just gonna focus on like the outer corner of my eye. So I'm like the outer edge of my eyebrow. But yeah, after I finish training tomorrow, I'll be going straight back to Wakefield, and then, so it's like a 2-hour journey. So I don't know what time my train is. I think my train's at like 5:30 or something like that. So it means that I won't get back till 7:30. And then I'm back at work Thursday from 12:30 till 9. And then I am, what am I doing after that? Oh, I'm doing freelance on Friday. So I've not even cleaned my kit from when I did Halloween. And it's awful. I've cleaned all my brushes though, so they're done. That's the main thing. But I do need to give my kit a bit of a clean over. I've got quite a few bookings. And then I'm back at work Saturday and Sunday. So put the straighteners in. I want to know what's going on. I want to know if I'm going out for dinner. I might just go out on my own. To know if this popcorn is, if we have to pay for it. I don't think we do, you know. I think it just, oh, you can order food. Maybe I should order food if like no one wants to go out. I don't think it's gonna get any better, is it? I think you just can't improve perfection, can you? I'm joking. This is Drew on the go. Ugh, look at that highlight. I dyed my brows the other day, so I don't really need to use a lot of brow product. And I dyed my eyelashes, but made no difference. But yeah. I've decided I'm gonna have some Botox again. I've had Botox before. I'm gonna have some Botox again, just to stop me from doing that. And I might have my smile lines filled in. I don't know whether I should like have my filler taken out to then have it put back in a different shape. Like I really want that line, you know, that dent there. Not happening. And at some point in my future, I'm gonna get this tooth fixed because it's got a little chip in, and this one's not a real tooth, it's a veneer. Just putting out there, basically, like a little fact about me. So I was at my friend's house, right, and we was having, I think it was like fajitas or something. And, like, I bit down, and when I bit down, like, there was this massive, like, crunching noise, and I was in so much pain, and we was like, oh my god, what's happening? At first, I thought, like, my tooth had fallen out or something. Like, I thought it just cracked and it had come out, and I was looking and my friend was looking, like, literally could not tell at all what had happened. But this tooth was just, like, in so much pain. It was ridiculous. Anyway, like, over a few days, like, the pain started to slightly go, and then over a few days, like, I was, like, brushing my teeth, and then I was like, why is that tooth going grey? And I thought, has it always been grey and I've never really noticed? And I was like, well, it can't be, because I get them bleached and stuff. So I looked it up, and it said that, you know, if you damage your tooth, it'll go grey, and it's because the nerve gets killed. So I automatically was like, right, that's what I've done. I broke my tooth, I've killed the nerve. So I booked an appointment at the dentist, and I was like, oh, I'm due a checkup anyway, but I think I've damaged my tooth, that I need it checked out. So I got there, and she did all, like, the tests and stuff, and she was like, yeah, like, the tooth's died, you've got no nerve there anymore. So I had to have, like, a root canal. And then the only way for the tooth to not be grey is they gave me the option of having a veneer. So that tooth, I have a veneer on. But what I didn't know was, like, the veneer was going to be a little bit bigger than my tooth that I had before, so I can no longer wear my bottom retainer. So even though my teeth are pretty much straight, this one here, you can see, like, it's slightly not straight. And that's because this tooth, when I first had it done, it was so bulky, it's like misaligned my teeth. So I had braces for all them years, and they're not perfectly straight like they used to be, but they are straight. It's just annoying. But I only have, if you notice as well, I only have 3 teeth here. And then I have my, like, fangs. And that's because the 4th tooth that I used to have grew behind this one. So I had to have that taken out. And then these 2 teeth here, they used to stick out. So my teeth used to be like that. So they were like these 2. And then these 2 like fingers were these 2 teeth. And that's how my teeth used to be. So at front arm, they looked straight. But then the side, they used to stick out. And the only way they could straighten my teeth out is by removing 2 more teeth. So I had a tooth taken out here, here. So the tooth that was there, I had taken out, and then they pushed them back, and then they straightened my teeth out. And I've now got straight teeth. So I still have to wear my retainer now and again, and it's annoying. But yeah, I wear it maybe like every couple of weeks. I usually wear it a few days in a row, and then I stop wearing it, and then I wear it in a few days in a row again. That's just a little bit of info about me. I originally thought, oh, do you know what, I'm gonna have a really wild vlog. It's gonna be crazy. I'm gonna go out in London, film a lot, but I'm not even joking. I feel shocking. I feel so poorly. Like, maybe about 20 minutes after I'd done my hair and makeup, like, my head's been pounding all day, but it's just getting worse. And I've taken headache tablets, but it's just not shifting. I don't know if I'm coming down with something. I am poorly again. Like, I was poorly the other day. Like, I had a really bad stomach. Like, a really bad stomach. I don't know if it's, like, just been a long day. I think it's best I just stay in bed. I think it's because I got up so early this morning, and then I travelled on the train. You know, I've been under, like, that yellow lighting all day. And it's just, like, I think it's just getting to me, and I think I'm just so exhausted and tired. I think it's catching up. But yeah, I don't feel worse. I've just taken all my makeup off. Or most of it. Probably still got a little bit on my eyes, to be fair. I thought I'm gonna have a bit of a sleep, and then maybe talk to Gavin when he finishes work. I wanted this vlog to be really exciting and fun. and it's just me like poorly. I hope my headache goes. Morning guys, so I've just had a shower, obviously. I've just dried my hair. I'm just gonna quickly straighten it. And then just like, I'm gonna go and get some breakfast. And then obviously go to my training. So it's my last day in London. I'm going back today. I should get home about 7. And then I'm back at work tomorrow, 12:30 till 9. So yeah, busy, busy week. I'm back at work Friday doing freelance. So lots of money. My hair looks so ash in this camera. Looks amazing. I really need to get my roots done though. Look at that. I was so poorly after I come off yesterday. Like, I went to sleep about 7:10 because I felt shocking. I was so poorly. Like, I didn't end up going out. But I think B went out with Camoon anyway because I think Camoon invited her to a Halloween party and I didn't know about it. So I didn't have anything anyway. I only had like this set of clothes and then like a t-shirt. So I didn't have anything dressy. So obviously I couldn't go out. And I just thought we were going out for dinner, but obviously not. So yeah, I was really poorly. And I woke up at like 2 a.m. and then like I messaged Gavin and he just finished work at midnight. So I was talking to him for a bit on FaceTime and then I had to go out to the shop to get some like headache tablets. So I got like some Nurofen and then I got some like Lemsip and stuff. But yeah, like I felt awful. It was not nice at all. So yeah, I think, you know, it's like, because it was a long day and I was travelling, I think it just took it out of me. But anyway, I'm gonna go and I'm gonna go get something to eat and I will see you soon. I don't know if I'll be able to film much today because my battery is literally like on the 1 bar and I thought I fully charged it, but obviously not. So yeah, anyway, if I don't see you later, I will see you in my next vlog. Bye. Hey guys, so just got back home and decided to have a lovely bubble bath. Training went really, really well. We did like Halloween looks and I obviously did Harley Quinn on my friends because I love Harley Quinn and I'm a comic nerd. So yeah, I got back just after 7 and I have watched a lot of YouTube and I need to get a bath, but I needed to end the vlog, so I'm home. Sorry it's not been super exciting. My adventures obviously got short-lived because I got poorly. But I'm hoping to be better soon, so I'm going to do some filming next week, and then I'm also going to do some looks next week. So I really want to start cosplaying, and I'm really feeling like Supergirl and like Starfire. And a few more. Maybe like Poison Ivy. Maybe I should redo a Poison Ivy. So I need to get a couple of props and stuff. But yeah, I really need to get back on my Instagram because I've been really bad with it. So thank you all for watching. Please keep subscribing. Hit that notification button. And yeah, just give this video a thumbs up, you know, and leave a comment down below. I try and comment to everybody. I try and reply to all your comments. So yeah, just let me know what you want to see in the future. So peace out. Bye. Let's end the video with this. Ready? Mwah. It's snowing.